In this series, we've travelled from prehistory to the present day, from labs to Martian lands. As we've told those stories, another story has emerged in the background. Gold has so often been the spark that ignited change. Through technological breakthroughs, medical revelations, and cultural revolutions, time after time, gold has played a role as an initiator and accelerator. In more ways than meets the eye, this element is one of the sparks of our modern world.
We've seen how gold has touched aerospace, electronics, culture, medicine, and more. Its impact is omnipresent, even when it's not necessarily in plain sight. There is gold in the screen that you are using to watch this episode. There's gold in the data centers that are helping to stream it to you. It has a role everywhere. So how is it that one element ended up touching so much of our world?
Because gold is so often the tool we rely on when imagination strikes. Gold's remarkably diverse and dependable properties help us realize our creativity and innovation. So it's no wonder that gold is often present at the first stages of research and development, when researchers are beginning to answer a question.
When people are looking to create a prototype, they look to gold because it's a model system, it's a model metal, and it has all of the perfect properties that we need to understand the science on a fundamental scale.
Gold has been a spark for science across its evolution. Like in 1909, when Ernest Rutherford famously used gold to demonstrate the structure of an atom, a foil sheet revealing an invisible world. Over 100 years later, scientists continue to use the metal in attempts to answer some of our most pressing challenges. Like Dr. Leila Giron, who is using the gold-containing drug Auranofin, not for its original purpose of treating rheumatoid arthritis, but to potentially treat HIV patients.
Auranofin is an organogold compound, meaning it has this organic part binding to a gold element on it. We know gold has anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial properties. We know HIV, its big part is inflammation disease. So we conducted a clinical trial that aim to decrease the HIV reservoir in the HIV individual. And Auranofin was in one of these studies. Finding a cell that has HIV inside is like finding a needle in a haystack. But what Auranofin does, it goes to these cells that has the HIV inside and make them mature faster. So they will mature faster and they will die soon. It's really amazing and just show how good drug repurposing can be.
Across our whole research and development landscape, gold consistently sparks progress and innovation, sometimes invisible, consistently impactful. And one thing we're coming to understand about gold is the changes it can ignite. These amazing developments from often hidden or distant sparks will continue to change our world.
Here is some gold that became a bracelet, but it could so easily have been part of an electrical circuit, or in the sensors of an airbag, or in the coating of a gilded skyscraper, and it still could. Gold came here to Earth billions of years ago, and it's still surprising us with what more it can do.
Today, gold's potential to be recovered and reused is evolving. At Mint Innovation in Auckland, scientists are trying a new approach to strike gold with microbes.
Typically, gold's used in printed circuit boards because it's very conductive and it doesn't corrode. How we process these circuit boards is we receive them from a recycler and we grind it to a sand. Then we put this through a series of mild leach steps to dissolve the various metals. When we've dissolved these metals, we've employed these special microbes that can go into these solutions and specifically pull out metals like gold and concentrate them to themselves. And so then all we need to do is recover these microbes like a fishing hook from the sea of metals we're casting into. There you go, you've got your concentration and purified gold.
That gold can go back into the circular economy, perhaps as a new device or as a piece of treasured jewellery. Gold has been on Earth since Earth was forming. Once humankind came upon it, gold became a tool for ingenuity. It sparked changes that have shaped our modern world. For millennia, we searched for gold. Now, we're finding its potential. We've followed gold's bright past and bold future through realms of aerospace and electronics, medicine and science, art and culture. We've seen how it somehow sparks what's new while being woven into the very basis of human civilization.
Now, as we face larger and greater challenges, how will gold help us to innovate? How will it help us to reach that future that we are just beginning to imagine? What will gold spark next?